Okay, so right now I'm gonna eat my breakfast, and this is I buy on my own. I buy by myself, and this one is my working colleague called Ramli. So he buy this sardine sandwich for me. Okay, so thank you very much to Ramli for buying me this sardine sandwich. That's right. Oh, it's two. It's real. Okay. Oh shit. Oh my god. This is not a good shot. Okay.
Oh, yes, what's this?
Shower.
Huh?
Shower?
Shower? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, okay. Oh.
Okay, so the sandwich, sardine sandwich, is my working colleague Randy buy for me. And then this one, the Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola is my this working colleague called Sabah. So he treat me Coca-Cola, okay. So once again, thank you very much to both my working colleague, okay. Thank you very much to my this two working colleague. Okay, for treat me eat the sardine sandwich and then also the Coca-Cola. That's right. Okay. Oh, it's two. It's real.
Just 19 days from WrestleMania, and we will welcome you tonight to your Monday Night Raw.
I gotta tell you, that never gets old. That's why I do this. Yeah, listen, I know why I'm here. Providence, y'all know why I'm here. So Finn Balor, get out here right now so we can finally be done with this. WrestleMania? Fine. You got it.
Did you hear that, Dom? Did you hear that? Lee, did you hear that? Finn's going to WrestleMania. Hey, and you think the beating I gave you at Extreme Rules was bad?
Shut your mouth! Now you can hear me talk. Because for the last year of my comeback, I've wasted it with all of you. The year before that, I wrestled in front of a bunch of TV screens in the Thunderdome. I don't have time for this. I need to accomplish what I need to do before I can be done. I'm running out of time. So, Finn, you pulled the Judgment Day out from under my feet. You did that. You did. And here's the thing. You made the Judgment Day better. I can admit it. Because you leaned into what those three are, which is bitter, immature, malcontents. Yeah, you got this weird hybrid thing now. You're like an Irish, Australian, Mexican, Puerto Rican emo delight. Yeah. It sounds like a bougie drink you'd order at your local hipster coffee joint. But whatever, because it's worked. Every other week, you have left me laying. You made me utter two words I never thought would fall out of my face when I said, I quit. Still bashed Beth's skull in with a concerto. For the last year, you have tried to make my life a living hell. And a lot of the time, you've accomplished it. So the way I see it, there's only one way that this can end. WrestleMania, Edge versus Finn Balor inside Hell in a Cell.
And it spit me out because hell couldn't handle my demons. I'll see you at WrestleMania. But until then,
oh no, come on. Balor looking to sick the Judgment Day on the Rated R Superstar. We're going to see Balor and Edge inside Hell in a Cell.
Yeah, but for now it's 3-on-1. Priest, Dominic Mysterio, Rhea Ripley's now inside the ring.
The numbers are just overwhelming Edge. Trying his best to stand his ground, but now the Rated R Superstar being victimized by the Judgment Day, by his own creation.
Less than 3 weeks away, but hang on a second.
Gargano and Loomis and Candice LeRae.
LeRae goes straight for Rhea Ripley.
Moment at least.
Look at Loomis go.
We got a scheduled match in a preview right now.
Johnny Gargano just pulling Dominic Mysterio all over him. It's Johnny Gargano and Dexter Loomis teaming for the first time ever on Raw against the Judgment Day. Dominic Mysterio and Damian Priest.
As you can see, some semblance of order has been restored. We're in the midst of a sanctioned tag team matchup. But what about the news? Directly before the commercial break, Edge laid out the challenge. Balor accepted Hell in a Cell at WrestleMania.
They left everybody stormed here in Providence, Rhode Island. WrestleMania, just 19 days away.
Fantastic counter by Johnny Wrestling. A step ahead of Dominic.
Johnny Wrestling says, bring it on. Oh, vicious kick to the head of Dominic. A little nervous on the outside.
I don't know that Rhea's nervous so much she's concerned, KB. Here comes Damian Priest, the powerhouse, the punishment of the Judgment Day. Priest and Gargano certainly no strangers to one another, dating all the way back to their time in NXT.
Heard Edge mention Puerto Rico, the home country of Damian.
Loomis will see his first action of the night. Minority here, but I happen to personally find Dexter Loomis far more disturbing than any member of the Judgment Day.
Yeah, you're on your own, man. Absolutely on your own. Priest, my skin crawl. Working that left arm of Dexter Loomis.
The ring.
Damian Priest taking to social media saying he's here to handle business for the Judgment Day after Johnny Gargano's victory over Finn Balor last week with the help of Edge.
Damian Priest has been on a tear in recent months here on Monday Night Raw. How do you prepare for that?
Come on, Priest. Don't be scared of him.
You see the athleticism of Dexter Lumis, and you know that somewhere in the back of his mind he's wondering what your flesh would look like as a lampshade. Oh, big right hand by Priest.
Priest now teeing off on Lumis in the corner. Johnny Gargano watching on.
In the business of the Judgment Day. Certainly not a sound strategy to anyone who's crossed paths in recent months with Priest or Dominic or Rhea. Oh!
Drop kicking Priest who goes to the outside. The emotionless Dexter Lumis.
See the intensity, the fire in the eyes of Damian Priest. Super frustrated and taken down in a drop toehold. Very sound, basic wrestling skills on display.
Tag me. Here comes Johnny Wrestling. Brilliant tag team action from Lumis and Gargano.
With one right hand by Priest changes the momentum of the matchup.
Candice LeRae, the wife of Johnny Gargano, watching on. Oh. Face first.
Snake Eyes in the turnbuckle.
Tag me. Just in time. Look at Johnny Wrestling go. Featured on NXT on Tuesday night. He's headed to Stand and Deliver to take on Grayson Waller April 1st.
Oh, Dom right between the eyes. Priest needs an uppercut.
On the apron now. Gargano taking flight. The devastating effect. The Judgment Day in trouble here. To Monday Night Raw. We're live tonight in Providence, Rhode Island. The packed house watching Johnny Gargano try and fight back here now against Damian Priest. It's tag team action. Gargano, Dexter Lumis, and Priest, and Dominic Mysterio.
Gargano desperately in need of a tag and a pressure. Lumis, but Priest wisely chucking Johnny back into the corner of the Judgment Day. And here comes Dominic. I understand Netflix is actually making a documentary about the crime life of Dominic Mysterio.
Yeah, quick documentary. Tag man. Priest back inside now. Gargano's in a perilous position.
Oh, but I for one cannot wait to watch Grayson Waller knock Gargano's teeth down his throat at NXT Stand and Deliver. Oh, broken arrow by Priest.
Puts the leg for the victory and a kick out by Johnny Gargano. Johnny Wrestling still alive as his wife Candice LeRae and Dexter Lumis watch on.
I think Candice is going to be feeling Stand and Deliver. Before we get the Stand and Deliver coming up next, I hope we reinforce the ring tonight. A true super heavyweight face-off. Lesnar and Omos face-to-face live in Providence.
Over 700 pounds between the behemoths, Lesnar and Omos.
Homage to Uncle Eddie.
And Rhea's enjoying it. The boos ring out.
What mommy wants, mommy gets. Mommy enjoys it. Dominic delivers.
Dominic now grabs the leg for the win to put away Johnny Gargano, who's still alive. Official earlier on, the Judgment Day's Finn Balor will take on Edge and Hell in a Cell.
Cell match at WrestleMania.
Johnny Gargano trying to fight his way back into this matchup.
He's got so much resolve, but Dominic puts him against the ropes. Oh, there we go. Dial it up. Johnny now.
Spear through the rope. Dom is down. Can Johnny make the tag?
It's got a moment. Can Johnny Gargano get back on his feet here? Gargano gets across to Loomis. Look at the power of Dexter Loomis.
Oh, man. Big time spine buster, and one for Dominic as well.
Two for one on the Judgment Day. And Loomis a pace now. Oh!
Bulldog face first.
Yeah.
Big belly of back suplex by Loomis.
And the kick up. Now, to put away Damian Priest, what a win this would be! Priest kicking out. What a match to kick off Monday Night Raw.
Moments away from Lesnar and Omos. So much still to come tonight. Priest sent to the outside.
Loomis is rocked. Dominic will see this is his chance now. He gets the victory. The feet are on the ropes.
The poison pixie sticking our nose where it doesn't belong.
Making sure justice is served.
And now,
watch it.
Reascending to the stairs.
Inside we go. Priest now. Look at the hand, Dexter Loomis.
Tag is made and Dom from the top.
Dog splash. Grabs that leg. The Judgment Day and Dominic Mysterio. No! Johnny Gargano! Johnny Gargano saves it.
At the last possible second.
Get him!
Get him. The words are Rhea Ripley from the outside. Sending Damian Priest in.
Super kick by Johnny. Gargano building up
the feet. Oh! Priest all over the announce desk.
The Dom from behind takes advantage of the situation. Dom now one-on-one with Dexter Loomis.
Loomis. He's trying to turn it around now.
Oh, no. The submission's locked in. This
Dom's got nowhere to go.
The head and arm triangle of Dexter Loomis. The tag was made. Loomis unaware.
Oh, my. Vicious from Priest.
Sound of heaven.
Good night, Dexter Loomis.
Superstar Edge. better playground.
Oh, man, cannot wait for that one. Now, folks, let's go backstage to earlier on tonight. Our broadcast colleague, Kathy Kelly, trying her best to catch up with the host of WrestleMania, The Miz.
We are officially on the road to WrestleMania here tonight in Providence, Rhode Island for Monday Night Raw. Now, the superstars are arriving to... Excuse me, Miz?
Hey, either one of you seen Otis. Literally just arrived at the arena. How would I have seen him? Actually, it's entirely possible. I don't travel with my pets like you do. If you're looking for your missing dog, go put flyers. I have an interview.
Shush! Flyers. That's what I was thinking.
Gotta go. Thank you. You were asking?
Yes, I wanted to ask you about WrestleMania to see if you would consider having a co-host.
What kind of do you want to be my co-host? I mean, there's only one star big enough to host WrestleMania.
Trish Stratus being attacked by all three members of Damage Control. It was Trish who sort of cost Damage Control the WWE Women's Tag Team Championship when she arrived. Obviously, Damage Control hasn't forgotten.
Yeah, no surprise there. Damage Control with a numbers advantage coming up on the Hall of Famer, Trish Stratus. Speaking of WrestleMania, my cheery giant is here.
Please welcome.
Way toward the ring for an absolutely massive showdown. In a matter of moments, Omos will come face to face with the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar, live on Monday Night Raw.
£7'3", £416. You are looking at the Nigerian Giant, Omos.
WrestleMania, we will witness a true super heavyweight showdown as the Nigerian Giant Omos goes one-on-one with the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar. The Goliaths will come face-to-face in a matter of moments.
Brock Lesnar! Brock Lesnar, you are a brilliant athlete, but a terrible tactician. You made a critical error putting your hands on me last week or 2 weeks ago, but the worst, the biggest mistake you've ever made in your career was accepting a match against the 7'3", 416-pound Nigerian Giant Omos at WrestleMania. Brock, I want you to understand that...
to do, and the Beast is in Providence.
Omos said last week that he would be the one to tame the Beast. Brock Lesnar, but look at this man. Brock Lesnar, there the physical specimen.
Nothing resembling fear in the eyes of the Beast Incarnate as Lesnar circles the ring like a great white shark.
Yeah, but of course, if he's a great white shark, then Omos is a megalodon.
A great analogy, KP. I didn't know you knew your dinosaurs. battle one of the largest opponents he has ever faced in his career.
Thank you. solution for the American nightmare.
Down goes LA Knight.
Stripped by the veteran. Bro, it's at a knee, right?
right between the eyes.
Cody may put this away early now. Cover and a kick out by LA.
Smart move by Knight. Taking a moment to compose himself. Oh, Cody is looking to afford LA.
Cody's caught. Cody's been caught.
Big right hand by Knight. Stops the nightmare in his tracks.
Dragon Rhodes to the outside. Such a connection there from LA Knight, but now face first into the barricade. Bit of urgency about Cody Rhodes now.
Oh, but the urgency may cost him. You are dealing with a veteran in LA Knight.
It's Cody Rhodes.
LA took his eye off the ball for just a moment, and now the nightmare is making him pay.
A separation gain inside the ring for LA Knight. Cody Rhodes taking a climb. LA at pace now. Wow!
Are you kidding me?
Is the American Nightmare in trouble?
He sure is.
We are 19 days from WrestleMania and the biggest night of Cody Rhodes' life with a main event against Roman Reigns. And look at Cody Rhodes go inside the ring in one-on-one action against LA Knight.
Smart move by Knight. The official's view is blocked by their bodies. Knight went to the eyes. DDT just
could do it. LA Knight now, what a win this would be. Cody, shoulders up.
A WrestleMania weekend, a colossal two-night event kicks off 2 weeks from this Saturday. And LA Knight is a superstar still looking for a path. If you talk to Knight, he believes in his heart of hearts that he belongs at the showcase of the Immortals. Some people may say that LA Knight's brash, maybe that he's a bit overconfident, but that's the sort of mentality it takes to make your mark in this business. And LA Knight could be well on his way with a win tonight over Cody Rhodes.
Imagine the talk, the chatter, if LA Knight can get this done against a man headed to the main event of WrestleMania.
Just think psychologically what it could do to Cody. Picking up speed. Forearm caught Knight off guard. Big uppercut.
LA Knight's rocked to the corner. He goes, evaded by Cody. Cody's looking fresh.
Power slam by Rhodes, and now it's Knight in jeopardy.
Looking energized. Cody Rhodes.
A disaster kick.
Hooks the leg now. Cody to put away LA Knight, who kicks out at two. Cody can't believe it.
Cody keeping his focus now on LA Knight, who no doubt is earning Rhodes respect as this match progresses. But Cody can't lose sight of the task at hand. LA Knight stands in the way of WrestleMania right now.
Caught by LA Knight. Can he
cover
in this now? LA Knight cover for the win. Cody kicks out of two.
Knight beginning to show a little frustration. Looking for blunt force trauma. Rhodes able to escape.
Cody. Hang on. Look at this. Cody cutter.
Wow. Cody. The American Nightmare wouldn't
from Mr. Heyman that I should stay out of Bloodline business. Well, I reiterate, I do not work for the Bloodline, and I don't work for Mr. Heyman. So if I want to come out here, stand side by side with Sami Zayn, I can do that. If I want to come out here and fight alongside Kevin Owens, I can do that. And I also hear Mr. Heyman say, don't make this personal. Personal. What a joke. It has been personal since I first appeared on this show at 21 years old in front of these same cameramen. It's personal when week after week I'm choked up, fighting back tears with every sentence. It's personal when you wear a protective coat of armor, and I'm not talking about my robe. I'm talking about a tailored suit, and the reason I wear it is not because I think I am somebody. It's because I want to be somebody. Mr. Heyman talking about acknowledging Roman Reigns, I acknowledge you, damn it. You need to acknowledge me. I am not perfect, but my time since I came back to the WWE has been perfect. I am undefeated. I grew up thinking that I was a prince in this industry. But I've got no crown, no chip, no master sword, no undisputed WWE Universal Championship. And on April 2nd, when the sun goes down on Hollywood, it is going down on Roman Reigns' generational run. On April 2nd, it's not just those who've got the Rhodes and the Runnels blood pumping through their veins. It's every single person who has followed me until the end. On April 2nd, I have waited my whole life. I will wait no more. On April 2nd, Roman Reigns, I pin you, I stick you in this ring, and become the first Rhodes to ever say he is the undisputed WWE Universal Champion.
Incredible passion, incredible poise, a highly motivated challenger for the Tribal Chief and the undisputed WWE Universal Championship. Rhodes, Reigns, WrestleMania.
I fired up everybody here in the arena here tonight in Providence.
You need not look at the eyes of the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes. You may not be sold on it, but Cody is sold on it. WWE Universe is too.
When the sun goes down on April 2nd in Hollywood, it's going down on Roman's generational run. Wow. Serious word there from Cody Rhodes. He said it's all very personal for him. Just like it is for Seth Rollins. When last week on Raw, he went face to face for the first time with Logan Paul.
The time for talk is over. It's time to fight.
No, 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 because one thing I don't do is fight for free. I am a premium act. If we were somewhere there was a little more, I don't know, star power, I'd consider it.
I am the host of WrestleMania. I could make Seth freaking Rollins versus Logan Paul at WrestleMania happen. You can make that happen?
Yes, I'm right here.
What are we waiting for? Let's go, Mike.
turn. When you wake up, let me know about WrestleMania. Bye-bye, bitch.
Please welcome Seth freaking Rollins. Seth, what's your reaction to Logan Paul knocking you out with a sucker punch last week?
Logan. Saxon, last week my man Logan, he was acting like he won the lottery. And do you know why? Do you know why? Because he did. He landed the shot of a lifetime right here on this chin. He knocked me down. But if there's one thing we've learned about Seth freaking Rollins over the past 2 years, it's that you can't keep me down. So the next time Logan Paul and
jealous that Logan Paul knocked you out cold with one single punch. Face it, you lost control of the narrative, Seth. At least that's the way it looks to me, but what do I know? Except for the fact that I am the host of WrestleMania and I get privileged information. For example, next Monday night on Raw, Logan Paul will conduct an in-ring live exclusive WWE edition of Impulsive TV. And I also know that I am expected to be invited as a guest.
Oh,
yes, right. Hey, hold, did you say guest? Look, my schedule just cleared up, so I'm available.
Oh, yeah, I believe Logan is all booked up. Sorry.
WrestleMania, two nights, you're the host, you got a lot on your plate, let me be your co-host, we can take it over, you see it now, you and me, co-host WrestleMania.
Corbin, I have a lot of pool for WrestleMania.
Come on,
but I don't have that much pool.
Come on. Seth, check it out, Logan did knock you out pretty quick, and I'm a three-time Golden Gloves champion. So, hey, you and me, I'll give you some boxing lessons, get you ready for WrestleMania.
Corbin, I appreciate the offer. I do. I understand where you're coming from. I know you're going through some tough times right now. You just need a break. But if I'm being honest, I would rather take boxing lessons from my baby daughter.
Yes. I mean, come on, man. I'm trying everything here. Your daughter's 2.5. She doesn't know anything. Look, matter of fact, you're lucky it's not me and you out there tonight, because I'd knock you out faster than Logan did, and then I'd take the spot at WrestleMania.
Oh, is that so? Does that sound like a challenge? Lucky for you, lucky for Providence, freaking Rollins is in a fighting mood, so let's make it official. You, me, tonight. I'll see you out there, buddy.
Said, hope to Bronson Reed and say, I want to fight you. Boone said,
Johnson had on his return to Boston. He verbally chewed O'Perry on on Spirit Alley. But Austin Theory ultimately got what he wants. We'll revisit next.
I'm standing by backstage with the superstar set to face Solo Sikoa tonight in a street fight, Kevin Owens. Now, Kevin, tonight you face Solo Sikoa. In the past, you faced every member of the Bloodline, but refused to ask for help from Sami Zayn this go around. So, can I ask why, given your history with him?
Yeah, I don't. I asked for help. I needed help for a long time, and I didn't get it. See, what I think has been happening lately is Sammy's the one asking me for help, right? But, look, with the history between us, like you mentioned, is it really that hard to understand why I wouldn't want to fight alongside Sami Zayn? Right? It's not. Look, I wish him the best. I really do. But I whatever he's got going on, I just don't want any part of it. And I'm fighting on my own. I don't need him. And you know what else? Cody Rhodes. I heard what you said earlier, and I saw what you did last week, helping out Sammy. And you look, you want to help out Sammy out, that's your problem. But like I told you last week when we talked, I don't need your help. I don't want your help. So tonight, when I'm out there with Solo Sikoa in that street fight, I mean what I said. I do not come out there. Because what I need you to do is focus on WrestleMania and Roman Reigns. Biggest match of your career, the night you waited for your whole life. And I don't want to be the reason why it doesn't happen. So Cody, tonight, I don't want to see you out there. Tonight, I want to fight Solo Sikoa and whoever else he might have with him, let's be honest, right? I want to fight those guys on my own, like I've been doing, and like I'm going to keep doing. And I'm perfectly fine with that. Thanks.
Kevin Owens, obviously a man on a mission. Going solo against Solo Sikoa, I don't know how well that's going to work out for the prize fighter. It could be a very lonely evening for Kevin Owens.
Well, it was anything but lonely last Monday night when arguably the greatest of all time, John Cena, returned to Raw at his hometown of Boston, and he was greeted by 16,000 of his closest friends.
Your time is up. The time is now. The 16-time world champion, the one and only John Cena, returns. Disrespect me, because I came out here with a gift for you, John. It's a gift of me and you on the grandest stage of them all for the United States Championship, Austin Theory versus John Cena. No. I'm not interested in your gift because you haven't earned the right to give it. I've been watching you, and I've been listening to you, and I don't care. Just like every single person in here, we don't care about you. You have been given opportunity after opportunity after opportunity, and you don't believe in you, and they know it, and the opportunities aren't enough. You got no heart. You got no soul. You're a pair of trunks away from being a jabroni. You're wasting our time. So on behalf of Boston, we would like to give you a gift. Shut up. Turn around. Get out of the ring. And we will let you walk out of here in one piece. You have a golden ticket against the greatest United States champion at WrestleMania, and you're gonna give up? Where's the hustle? Where's the loyalty? Where's the respect, John? Where's the respect for all of them? You really are a dumb son of a bitch. I didn't say no because I gave up. I said no to save your ass. You're not ready. If you and I have a match at WrestleMania and I win, you lose everything. But you really left me no choice because you brought them into it. Do you want to see Austin Theory versus John Cena at WrestleMania? Remember this moment. You just made the biggest mistake of your life. I wish you luck, dude. You're going to need it. Because we all know you don't have it here. We all know you don't have it here. And we all know you don't have it here. Oh, wait.
wait, wait, wait.